Hello friends, welcome to Best Readouts. In this video, we will be solving paper 1 of Maharashtra SET exam, SET, State Eligibility Test. The paper is of June 2019. Before going for the studies, subscribe to my channel Best Readouts not to miss anything. Question 1. The reflective level teaching is option A, teacher-centered and subject-centered but not learner-centered. Option B, not teacher-centered but is subject-centered and learner-centered. Option C, teacher-centered and not subject-centered and learner-centered. Option D, neither teacher-centered not subject-centered but is learner-centered. The reflective level teaching has to be always learner-centered. So the correct option is option B. Question 2. The adult learner is peer-motivated, self-motivated, family-motivated, society-motivated. The correct option is adult learner is always self-motivated. That is option B. Question 3. Massive open online courses are flexible and open form of self-directed online learning designed for mass participation. Next option, flexible and open form of teacher-directed online learning designed for mass participation. Next option, flexible and open form of self-directed offline learning designed for mass participation. And last option given is flexible and open form of teacher-directed offline learning designed for mass participation. Now MOOC, that is massive open online courses, have to be flexible and open form of self-directed online learning designed for mass participation. Hence the correct option is option A. Question 4. Modern teaching support system includes option A, smart boards, B, green boards, C, charts, D, maps. Modern teaching always includes smart boards, which we are having now in the colleges. So the option is option A. Question 5. Which of the following is not applicable to the internal assessment? A, integration of teaching and evaluation. B, testing of skills and abilities. C, periodic and continuous. D, use of only achievement tests. Now we know use of only achievement tests is not the aim of internal assessment. Hence the correct option is option D. Question 6. Dialogue method of discovering truth was given by Plato, Socrates, Froebel and Herbart. The correct option is option B, Socrates. Question 7. If one variable is measured on nominal scale and other variable is measured on interval scale, the appropriate research method will be A, experimental method, B, case study method, C, cross-sectional method and D, correlation method. The correct option is option A, experimental method. Question 8. Which of the following is not a characteristic of good hypothesis? A, testability, B, objectivity, C, complexity and D, conceptual clarity. The correct option is complexity. As we know, hypothesis has to be testable, objective and conceptually clear. Question 9. If mean and median of a frequency distribution are 20 and 22 respectively, then the mode of the distribution will be. To get this answer, let us first solve this. So, let us see this question here. We'll solve this now. Let us see the values. Mean is equal to 20. Median is given as 22. Now the empirical relation between mean, mode and median is given by mean minus mode is approximately equal to, so let us write equal to 3 into bracket mean minus median. Now let us substitute. Therefore 20 minus mode equals 3 into bracket 20 minus 22. Therefore 20 minus mode equals 3 into bracket minus 2. Therefore mode equals, now changing the sides we get that as 20 plus 6, which equals 26. Hence the correct option is option C, that is 26. Question 10. Using someone else's research without your acknowledgement is called as copyright, plagiarism, publication and patent. Now as we know, the correct answer is plagiarism, option B. Next question. Directions. Answer question numbers 11 to 15 based on either the English passage or the Marathi passage. We'll read the passage now. I'm reading English passage. A sanctuary may be defined as a place where man is passive and the rest of nature active. Till quite recently, let me tell you, nature had her own sanctuaries where man either did not go at all or only as a tool using animal in comparatively smaller numbers. But now, in this machinery age, there is no place left where man cannot go with overwhelming forces at his command. He can strangle to death all the nobler wildlife in the world today. Tomorrow, he certainly will have done so unless he exercises due foresight and self-control in the meantime. There is not the slightest doubt that the birds and mammals are now being killed off much faster than they can breed. And it is always the largest and noblest form of life that suffer most. The whales and the elephants, lions and eagles go. The rats, flies and all mean parasites remain. This is inevitable in certain cases. But it is wanton killing off that I am speaking of tonight. Civilized man begins by destroying the very forms of wildlife he learns to appreciate most when he becomes still more civilized. The obvious remedy is to begin conservation. The obvious remedy is to begin conservation at an early stage when it is easier and better in every way by enforcing laws for close seasons, game reserves and selective protection of certain species and sanctuaries. I have just defined a sanctuary as a place where man is passive and the rest of nature active. But this general definition is too absolute for any special case. The mere fact that the man has to protect a sanctuary does away with his purely passive attitude. Then he can be beneficially active by destroying pests and parasites like boat flies or mosquitoes and by finding antidotes for diseases like epidemic, which periodically kills off the rabbits and thus starves many of the carnivores to death. But except in cases where experiment has proved his intervention to be beneficial. The less he upsets the balance of nature, the better, even when he tries to be an earthly providence. Now, question 11. In the passage, it is implied by author that his first definition of sanctuary is A. somewhat idealistic, B. quite wrong, C. completely unacceptable, D. difficult to defend. Correct option is option A, somewhat idealistic. Question 12. The author seems to be much concerned about the active role of man in protection of animals because A. he is afraid of the fact that it would lead to the imbalance of ecological system. B. he is sure that it is beneficial for the mankind itself. C. he thinks that the man's passiveness is not a sign of his being alive. D. he is more idealistic. The correct option is option A. He is afraid of the fact that it would lead to the imbalance of the ecological system. Question 13. The above passage can be A. a part of an article in a scientific journal. B. an argument in front of the court of law. C. a part of a speech delivered to an educated audience. D. an extract of a scientific report. The correct option is C. a part of a speech delivered to an educated audience. Question 14. The author intends to convey the message that A. man is quite a clever animal. B. if the man failed to maintain the ecological balance, it will be harmful in the long run. C. man wishes to destroy the wildlife as it is harmful for his existence. D. the balanced ecosystem will decrease the importance of man in the overall affairs of the universe. The correct option is option B. If the man failed to maintain the ecological balance, it will be harmful in the long run. Question 15. The tone of the author can be best described as being A. descriptive, B. humorous, C. narrative, D. sarcastic. The correct option is D. sarcastic. Question 16. According to Dr. Deval, communication means A. sharing of ideas, B. sharing of experiences, C. perception, D. sharing of emotions. The correct option is option C. Means, according to Dr. Deval, communication means perception. Question 17. To select media to teach a lesson to class, teacher should consider objectives of the lesson, age group of students, knowledge about media to be used, and A. teaching methods, B. teaching aids, C. mass media, D. evaluation system. The correct option is option D, evaluation system, because we have already considered the other options. The option which is left for the teacher is evaluation system. Question 18. Traffic signals are examples of dash communication. A. mass, B. nonverbal, C. verbal, D. one to many. The correct option, as we know, we get the signals as in the form of patterns or say symbols. It is nonverbal. So traffic signals are example of nonverbal communication, option B. Question 19. Customers coming to mall and sharing some common interest and group-based activities are steadily increasing. This is the example of dash group. A. open, B. closed, C. peer-to-peer, D. hierarchical. The correct option is, it is always a open group. Question 20. Sometimes mass media misleads society because receivers are A. heterogeneous, B. in large numbers, C. illiterate, D. critical. The correct option is heterogeneous. Question 21. In a game with two players X and Y, and given N is greater than or equal to 4, number of circles drawn on a plain paper, alternatively, each one of X and Y is supposed to join two circles, two different circles, which were not already joined by a line. The winner is the one who joins the last available pair of circles and the game ends. If X starts the game, then they have given four alternatives. Now let us see. Now let us take N as 4. There are 4 circles and X is starting the game. So X will join, suppose, these 2 circles, Y will join these 2, and Y wins. So X, the option A is X always wins, is wrong. Okay. Now let us take N as 5. 5 circles, X is starting the game, X is joining these 2, then Y is joining 3rd and 4th circle. Now X has left, he is having only 1 circle, so X loses. Okay, that is, now Y wins. Now, so X wins whenever N is odd is not true, because here N is odd, N equal to 5, and X is losing. So the option C is also not valid. X wins whenever N is odd. Example, N equal to 5, just now seen. Now let us take N as 6. We have 6 circles. Now X is starting. First 2 circles X has joined. Then Y has joined 3rd and 4th circles. Again X has joined the next 2. So X is the winner. So now Y always wins, that is option B, is also not true. So now let us go by reduction method. So now the only option left is option D. Y wins whenever N is the power of 2. Actually, this can be proven, but in our set exam, the timing is so less that reduction method many a times helps. So the correct option we are selecting as option D. Y wins whenever N is a power of 2. Question 22. In a classroom, there are 10 chairs in a row, C1, C2 up to C10, which are labeled by numbers 1, 2, 3 up to 10 arbitrarily, but satisfying the condition that Ki less than or equal to Kj whenever I less than or equal to j, where K1, K2, K3 up to K10 are the labels given to the chairs C1, C2, C3 up to C10 respectively. Then which of the following is true? We are given 4 options. Now we will try from the last option. The last option is this. For every I, Ki equals I, not 2. I will give you the example. Take the sequence of chairs as 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This satisfies the given condition. Now all labels distinct. That is given 1, 2, 3 up to 10, they are distinct. So what is so special about it? There are 2 I and J such that Ki equals I and Kj equals J need not be, as seen here. For the last option, the same example can be taken there. So the first option is correct. You can call this as a reduction method. For some I, Ki equals I. So option A, that is Ki, for some I, Ki equal to I is the correct option. Question 23. There are 25 flowers in a basket which are to be distributed to 5 persons standing in a row. The second person received half of the number of flowers given to the first person. The third person received half of the number of flowers received to the second person. The fourth person received half of the number of flowers received to the third person, and the fifth person received half of the number of flowers received to the fourth person. If the fifth person received only one flower and there is no flower remaining in the basket, how many flowers were there in the basket? Let us write down the given information in terms of symbols. Suppose five people are P1, P2, P3, P4 and P5. Now first person suppose gets n flowers. Second will get n by 2 flowers. Third n by 4 flowers. Fourth n by 8. And the last one will get n by 16 flowers. And we are given that last person gets 1 flower, so n by 16 is 1, therefore n equals 16. So that's why first person will get 16 flowers, second will get 8, third 4, next 2 and last one is 1. So total number of flowers are 16 plus 8 plus 4 plus 2 plus 1, that equals 31. So the correct answer is 31, that is option A. As it's raining outside, you might hear rain in the video. Now question number 24. If 6 men or 8 children complete one task in 24 days, then how many days will be required to complete the task for 7 men and 12 children? So let us see it here now. We are given 6 men or 8 children can complete one task in 24 days. It means 6 men are equivalent to 8 children. So 1 man is equivalent to 8 by 6, that is 4 by 3 children. Now we want to find 7 men and 12 children complete the task in how many days. Now let us convert 7 men and 12 children all into children, number of children. 7 men, when 1 man is equivalent to 4 by 3 children, 7 men are equivalent to 4 by 3 into 7. That is 28 by 3 children. Okay. So we want 7 men and 12 children. So now we are, for 7 men, it is 28 by 3 children plus 12 children, which gives us 64 by 3 children. So these 64 by 3 children, what it means, 7 men and 12 children equivalent to 64 by 3 children can complete the work in how many days? Now how to go about it? I've written it down, just we'll see it. Here it is. It is a child's work like he used to do in the school days. If 8 children can complete the work in 24 days, 64 by 3 children can complete in how many days? So that is the required answer. So answer equals 8 divided by 64 by 3 into 24, those many days. So that equals 8 into 24 into 3 by 64. Days, that equals 9 days. So here the correct option is option B, that is 9 days. Question 25. The area of a parallelogram is 128 centimeter square and its altitude is twice the corresponding base. What is the length of the base? Let us solve it now. Let us draw the parallelogram first. Alright. I am not so exact at drawing this, but opposite sides have to have equal length. Okay. Fine. This is a rough sketch as it is, just for understanding. So if base is B and altitude is A, we are given that altitude is twice the corresponding base. It means if base is B, altitude is 2 into B. Now, area of the parallelogram formula is
base into altitude. That is A into B. But A is 2B, so let us substitute it. Therefore, now we are given area is 128, that equals 2 into B square. A into B is 2B into B, 2B square. That's why area equal to 2B square is 128 equal to 2B square. Therefore, B square equals 64. Therefore, B equals 8. Here we are taking positive root as it is a length. So, the correct answer is option D. Here, answer D. That is 8 centimeters.
Question 26. Arrange the following terms in a meaningful logical order indicating correct sequence. 1 grass, 2 curd, 3 milk, 4 cow, 5 butter. Now, as we know, cow eats grass, gives milk, then we get curd and we get butter out of it. So, the correct sequence is option D, 4-1-3-2-5. Question 27. If the term HJLN is converted into ILOR, then by the same principle, what could be the correct alternative for the term DFHJ? I have already written now on the right side all the alphabets A to Z. So, I am underlining now HJLN. That is, they have selected alternate alphabets. And it is mapped to I, which is just next to H, L, O and R. That is, they left two alphabets in between. Now, they want for D, F, H, J, the alternative. Now, let us highlight by yellow color now. D, F, H, J would be mapped to what? Now, after H, they had selected I. So, here from the diagram, it is easily seen. So, first letter will come as E. Then, two left H. Two left K. In between two alphabets left, last one will be N. So, which is the correct option? Option B. That is EHKN as seen by the yellow circles.
Question 28. Parrots have green color. This statement is A. Perception, B. Inference, C. Comparison, D. Implication. Correct option, as we know it, is a perception. So, option A. Question 29. Which of the following is R, the valid conclusions based on the statements given below? Statement 1 is all donkeys are hardworking. So let us write it here. All donkeys hardworking. Now statement 2. Some hardworking animals are human beings. So in hardworking, we have some donkeys and other animals also here. And some hardworking animals are human beings also. So human being is a subset from here. So, conclusion 1. Some donkeys are hardworking. We can see. Yes. And conclusion 2. Some donkeys are human beings. Yes. A implies B, B implies C, that way. So, now answer. Option A, 1 only. B, 2 only. C, 1 and 2 both. D, neither 1 nor 2. We have seen, now correct option is option C, 1 and 2 both. Which of the following diagrams shows the correct relationship among boys, students and girls? Now looking at the diagrams, let us go by the reduction method. Now if bigger set here in the option B is students and some are boys and some are girls. Then what about the remaining? It can't be that way. All right. Now, this diagram. Entire is set of students. Now, smaller circle can be boys or girls, but it is not a subset of other. Suppose, for example, this is bigger circle is students. This if we'll assume as of boys. Girls will be subset of boys. That is not so. This is not valid. Now here, students, if this is boys, this is girls, they can't have common part. Intersection is not possible between boys and girls. Hence, the correct option is option A, this diagram.
Question 31. A report regarding certain examination is given below. Total number of candidates appear 1000. So, I am writing it simultaneously on the right side. Total candidates appear 1000, out of which males are 550 and females are remaining. So, obviously, there will be 450 as the total number of students is 1000. The number of past candidates is given to be 700. 700 is past students. So, the number of successful male candidates will lie between the limits. Let us see now. There are 550 male. Suppose all will pass out of 700. So, this is the maximum limit for passing of males. And now, minimum limit. 450 female. Suppose all 450 females pass. Then, out of 700 past candidates, how many are males? 250. So, this 250 is the minimum limit, minimum boundary, and maximum is 550 for number of successful male candidates. Hence, the correct answer is option B, 250 to 550. Question. Numbers 32 and 33 are based on the following information. First column states A to E. Second column, total number of male and female employees. Third column, ratio of number of males to that of female employees. And last column is for percent of postgraduate among total employees. Now, you can read the data here. Let us go to the questions and again come back to the data. Question 32. Find the number of male employees in the state D. So, this is state D. We want to find the number of male employees. Let us solve now. Total number of male and female employees is 40,000. We are given male is to female ratio is 14:6. It means now 14 plus 6 is 20, which means 14 out of 20 are males and 6 out of 20 are females. So, but total number of employees is 40,000. So, for males, total number of males is 14 by 20 into 40,000, which gives us the answer as 28,000. So, option, let us see, C is the correct option. Question 33. Find the number of postgraduate female employees in state B. Now let us go to the data again. State B is here. With the data we have highlighted. Now 30,000 total number of employees. We are asked the question about PG, number of postgraduate females. So out of 30,000, how many are females? They have said that percent of postgraduate students here is 50%. So, half of that is 50% of 30,000 is 50,000. 15,000, that is number of PGs, postgraduate persons. Now, we want females out of these. So, the ratio again, male is to female is 8:7. So, as seen earlier, 8 plus 7 is 15. So 8 by 15 males and 7 out of 15 females. So number of females who are postgraduate are 7 by 15 into total number of postgraduates, which gives us the answer as 7000. So the option, let us go to the option. Option D is the correct option. Question numbers 34 and 35 are based on the following pie diagram. We are given five regions. First is A, then B, then C, D, and E. All right. We are given the percentages for each sector. A is printing cost, B is cost of paper, C is royalty, D is advertisement charges, and E is other charges. Let us quickly calculate now here, even though just now it is not asked. X percent is how much? Now total of all percentages of A, B, C, D, and E has to be 100. So 35 plus 20 plus 15 plus 20% gives us 90%. So X percent is 10%. Now let us read the question. Question 34. If the cost of paper is rupees 16,000, then find the amount of other charges. Now cost of paper, as we can see from the diagram, that is part B, is 20%. Okay. Now if the total cost, that is A plus B plus C plus D plus E, the total cost of the paper, we will assume as Y, then cost of paper is 20% of Y, and that is given to be 16,000. So let us find Y now. Therefore, 20 by 100 into Y equals 16,000. Therefore, Y equals 80,000. So total cost of the paper is 80,000. Now, other charges are 10% as seen earlier. Here, X percent is 10%. All right. So we want other charges, 10% cost is how much? So here is the question again. The amount of other charges is 10% of the total cost, 10% of 80,000, which gives us the answer as 8,000. So option C is the correct option. Question 35. The tax deducted at source is 10% of the royalty amount, then the amount of tax paid is. Now let us see first how much is the royalty amount. From the graph, that is pie diagram, royalty C part is 15% of the total cost. Now we have found out total cost as 80,000. 15% of it on royalty. So that equals 15 by 100 into 80,000. That gives us the answer as, now zeros will get cancelled. So that comes to 12,000. All right. Now 10% of this royalty means 10% of 12,000 is the tax deduction. So that comes as 1200. That is our answer. So option A, rupees 1200, is the correct option.
Question 36. Which of the following is the correct full form of IPTV? A, International and Political TV Television. B, Internet Proliferation Television. C, Interprovisional Television. D, Internet Protocol Television. The correct option is option D, Internet Protocol Television. Question 37. The world's first computer, ENIAC, was developed in the year A. 1945, B. 1940, C. 1955, D. 1960. The correct option is 1945 A. Question 38. Which communication service has been recently closed in India? A. Postal service, B. Landline, C. Telegram, D. Fax. The correct answer is Telegram. It has been closed. So, C. Telegram. Question 39. For recruitment as a school teacher in Maharashtra, one must enroll himself / herself on the web portal A. Saral, B. Mahajobs, C. E-Seva, D. Pavitra. The correct answer is D. Pavitra. Question 40. Which statement among the following is not correct with respect to National Digital Library of India? A. It is a project by the Department of Technology. B. It is a virtual repository of learning resources with single window search facility. C. It is friendly to differently abled learners. D. It is being developed at an Indian Institute of Technology, Kharagpur, IIT Kharagpur. The correct option is it is a project by Department of Technology. It is not developed. So that is the correct option, option A. Question 41. Convention on Ozone Depleting Substances is also known as A. Basel Convention, B. Montreal Protocol, C. Ramsar Convention, D. Conference of Parties. So, Convention on Ozone Depleting Substances is also known as Montreal Protocol, that is option B. Next one, which is quite simple. Question 42. Unit used to measure noise level is A. Joule, B. PPM, C. Bit, D. dB means decibels. As we know, the correct answer is decibels D. Question 43. Green India Mission was part of the A. Millennium Development Goals, B. River Action Plan, C. Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, D. National Action Plan for Climate Change. The correct answer is Green India Mission is for National Act Plan for Climate Change. That is option D. Question 44. International Solar Alliance was established to develop cooperation in developing solar energy was proposed by A. Indian Prime Minister, B. French President, C. African Union, D. European Union. The correct answer is option A. Indian Prime Minister. Question 45. Concentration of toxic chemicals through food chain result into A. Accumulation, B. Excretion, C. Biomagnification, D. Elimination. The correct answer is biomagnification. Concentration of toxic chemicals through food chain result into biomagnification. Option C. Question 46. Technical and scientific education was given in A. Vedic system of education, B. Pre-Vedic system of education, C. Buddhist system of education, and D. Islamic system of education. The correct answer is C. In Buddhist system of education, technical and scientific education was given. Question 47. According to UGC list published, the state with the most universities is A. Uttar Pradesh, B. Maharashtra, C. Tamil Nadu, D. Rajasthan. Correct answer is Rajasthan. That is, according to UGC list published, the state with most universities is Rajasthan. Question 48. for creation and development of MOOC courses in different disciplines, MHRD has notified Dash is one of the 8 national coordinators. A. Mumbai Vidyapeeth, B. UGC, C. YCMOU, D. IIT Mumbai. The correct option is UGC, that is option B. Question 49. Most of the state universities are Dash in nature. A. Affiliating universities, B. Deemed universities, C. Self-financing universities, D. Private universities. The correct option is A. Most of the state universities are affiliating universities in nature. And we are towards the last question now, question 50. Which organization arranges administrative course for principals? A. HRD Ministry, B. UGC, C. NUEPA, D. NCTE. The correct option is option C, NUEPA.
Friends, thank you for watching the channel Best Redux.